I'm Kinsey Schofield. Here's your daily download. What's the craziest thing you've done while intoxicated? Don't answer that. These newlyweds bought a hotel on their honeymoon. We were so drunk is how they start this story. 33-year-old Gina Lyons and 35-year-old Mark Lee from London got so tore up from the floor up that they agreed to buy a small beachfront spot in Sri Lanka. The newlyweds agreed to take over a lease for 3 years, which cost around $40,000. After making the financial decision, the couple panicked, realizing that they were expecting a child. "We decided we'd have to make it work," they said. The couple told reporters that they reopened the 7-bedroom bed and breakfast at the end of July after about $8,000 of renovations. Business is allegedly booming, but they insist the next time they make a big decision, they're going to be sober. And T.I. has turned Twitter upside down with a tweet that reads, "Dear 45, I ain't Kanye." Attached is a video of the president boarding Marine One. The video cuts to T.I. in the Oval Office watching the helicopter take off. As he takes a seat at the Oval Office desk, a model closely resembling the First Lady walks in. She removes that notorious "I really don't care, do you" jacket in a striptease while T.I. lights a cigar. Stephanie Grisham, a spokeswoman for the First Lady, has called for a boycott of T.I.'s music, tweeting, "How is this acceptable?" And Make America Date Again. It's the slogan for the new Donald Trump-themed dating app, Donald Daters. The new dating app officially launched Monday on Apple and Android, and it provides a platform for Trump supporters to meet, mingle, with the goal of, what else, making America date again. The description says, for many young Trump supporters, liberal intolerance has made meeting and dating nearly impossible. Support for the president has become a deal breaker instead of an icebreaker. That's why we created a new platform for Trump supporters to meet people without being afraid of talking politics. The free dating app is similar to the other relationship apps like Tinder and OkCupid, so get ready for the most patriotic swipes of your life. And the U.S. Embassy in Australia had to apologize on behalf of the Department of State, who accidentally sent a test email featuring a photo of a cat dressed in a Cookie Monster costume. According to the Australian Associated Press, the photo was titled "Cat Pajama Jam" and was sent within an email titled "Meeting" as part of a test meeting invitation sent by the Department of State. The statement read, "It was a training error made by one of our new staff testing our email newsletter platform. It was also the most epic thing that's ever happened to the Department of State's inbox." And that's your daily download.
In today's Tech Bites,